Hello, everyone. This is Mr. Sheffield with your first Team Tuesday of the year. It is Tuesday, September the 10th, and we've got some things to talk about. The first of which is Team Tuesday. We haven't done this yet this year. Every year, it takes a little while to get the plane off the ground, so to speak, and get all of the things started for school. And this is about the time when I can finally crawl out from under the pile of work to deliver some information. So here we go. There'll be some technical difficulties, for sure, and I'm rusty. First of all, the thing you're going to do directly after this meeting is something called credit checks, and we are trying to refine this process. We're going to do it in classes this time, but it is super important that you pay close attention to that process because, one, it's going to tell you your graduation plan. I have already kind of plotted it out, but it is your responsibility to make sure I didn't screw it up. I refuse to be solely responsible for your graduation plan. You're in on it too. Secondly, that thing will tell you if you need any credit recovery courses, and if so, which ones and when. So I need you to be paying attention to that so that I don't miss any of those too, because those are super important. But those classes, if you have any to take, credit recovery courses, we use a software called Edgenuity, which you may be familiar with. To be perfectly honest, Edgenuity courses are soul-suckingly boring, and I don't know that you learn a lot. It's a lot of clicking and watching. It's not terribly engaging. Not in the way that your in-person classes are. However, it is the school board-approved method for us doing credit recovery, and so we love Edgenuity as a supplement to our very high-interest package of instruction-based learning that we have at school. So students can take up to one Edgenuity course per term to grab back some credits that maybe you lost in a previous failed class. But we'd like to do that strategically and in a managed way so that you might just have a bunch of those piling up in your schedule at high school. Here, all the parameters are set for you to do those classes within the quarter, and you have a pacing guide that is accurate, and the class has been cut to the appropriate amount of time for that term. So anyhow, we've had a lot of practice with this. These are the methods that work. Trust us a little bit, but also don't trust my credit checking work. Double check it. But they are super important. So those classes will start this week, maybe today by the end of the day, more likely tomorrow. But I need you to double check and see if you need those courses. So your input on the credit check sheet, when you get to that, will help me do that. Secondly, we have a very cool post-secondary or after high school opportunity coming up, which is the Build My Future Trade Industry Expo in October on Thursday the 17th. Mark Doherty, who does our career trips, is going to take our group of volunteers or people who are interested in going to Joplin to go talk to a bunch of people about potential job opportunities after high school. You can learn about different trades you might not know existed, or a little more about ones that you know do exist. On the forum, there are some pictures and I think a video explaining kind of what that is. You might get to use an excavator or do some welding or get in a bucket truck. There's all kinds of things in a wide variety of fields. So that is a really cool opportunity. Sign up if you're interested. This week, today we're having our first team meeting and credit checks. Super important. Super important. It's a little tedious. You know what tedious means? It's kind of boring. You have to pay attention, though. So even though you want to lose interest, you can't. In this case, you shouldn't, because it is so important. This is your plan to graduate. So focus when we get to that. And then Friday is midterm already? Yes, because we have 9-week quarter-length terms instead of semesters. Midterm comes even faster than the end of the quarter. Well, the quarter's, it's an eighth of the year. An eighth of the year has already gone by as of Friday. Wild. But this is a great time to take stock of your grades, see how things have gone so far.
I'll probably be calling your parents and your grandparents.
But it, like I say, it's a good just marker in the middle of the term. Like I said, it is just now that we are going to get credit recovery courses started for term one, but we're not unfair. Those will be cut proportionately so that you have time to complete what it is you need to complete. We will almost cut them in half for you. That's the only fair way to do that. But anyhow, if you're worried about the pacing of your credit recovery course, don't, because we've dealt with that. Picture days are coming up Wednesday, September 25th. Here in a minute, we'll take a look at the whole calendar. But Wednesday, September 25th is our picture day. So you want to look super nice. And then makeup day is Wednesday, October the 9th. Picture days in the morning, makeup days in the afternoon, in case you are not here for a half a day because of work or flex or whatever it may be. Those are our picture days. Calendar stuff. This is where we go to the calendar. So here is our website calendar. We keep calendars, so you don't have to. You can see over here, there's a million calendars. If you add our website calendar to your Google Calendar, which you can do a number of ways, ask your teacher or me or whatever, then when you go to Google Calendar, the additional calendar, our calendar, will show up as a choice for you to highlight. I only have like 10,000 of them. But down here, there's like the NSD Master Calendar, which tells you about PTO meetings at South or fall pictures at Carver. I don't have that one highlighted because a lot of that stuff doesn't apply to us. But here we are today. Today is the 9th. This isn't live. I'm not Bill O'Reilly. Tomorrow, Tuesday the 10th, that's today. In the future now, but you're today. We'll have a team meeting, credit checks, and credit recovery will begin. This Friday is midterm. We talked about that. Next week, not a lot on the calendar, but I believe we are going to be out early on the 20th. Apparently, there's not a lot of home football games this year, so I think homecoming is already next Friday. There's probably going to be theme days, which we'll announce when we get them. But on the 23rd, Monday, the following week, the Soroptimists, a community group that empowers women, is going to visit us and talk to our women at lunchtime, and I think they might have a little care package for you. I don't know all the details, but it's pretty cool that they want to support us. I say picture day is on Wednesday the 25th. On that Friday the 27th, we are going to have a ribbon cutting for our mural. That means the chamber will come. They'll bring a lot of suits to look official. We'll have a big ribbon, probably a big pair of scissors we do this with. I did contact Jared Jennings, our resident artist who did that project with us, and he is currently teaching. Who is here? Amazon. I'll be right back. I need that stuff. Oh, man. Transparencies or something. Cool. Where were we? Mural ribbon cutting. I think he's teaching in North Dakota. I don't know if Jared will be able to make it, but our friends at the Neosho Arts Council will be there. Lots of people from the community will be there. That should be fun. The following week, we have a field trip to Crowder. We're going to go see some folk art in the form of rug hooking. Also, don't know a lot about that, but that should be cool. And then on Friday the 4th, that is when our volunteers will go put the chalk art squares on the square for the chalk art competition the following day at the Neo Show Fall Festival. Any volunteers participating in the chalk art square putting on the square will get a free entry to the Neo Show Fall Festival chalk art contest. There's plenty of cash prizes to be won there. So you could leverage your $0 into a bunch of dollars if you participate in that. On our Team Tuesday page, there is still a chalk art volunteer sign up. You should have done that already if you were going to sign up, but it's still there. And you may still sign up if you're interested in that. There is also a photo album of that, so you can check out what that looks like. There is also a Build My Future interest form. That is the thing we talked about the trade show. You need to fill that out if you are interested. And you'll notice it's not a check yes or no. It's a explain why you'd like to go. And participants will be selected based on the quality of their responses. So I would like to just hear, you got to do a little bit of writing for me. Just a little bit. Okay. Next. We're going to move on to credit checks. This is going to take a while. I need you to be patient. I need you to work with your teacher. If you don't have that many credits, this won't take very long for you. I still need you to at least not be disruptive and let the rest of your classmates and your teacher work together, because this is, like I say, super important, a little tedious. It's going to take a while. But the resources for doing that are here, teachers. Team Tuesday, down here, credit check resources. There is a video tutorial that you will be able to play, pause, follow the instructions as you go along. I think we've done this enough times that this should go pretty smooth this time. And then only when you have finished with the first part, only then may you perform the credit check worksheet. Do not even think about doing this until you're already done with the first part. Okay, I believe that's the end of today's Team Tuesday meeting. I'm sure I've missed something or screwed something up in this process, but we'll get better as we go along. That's how learning works. Have a great rest of your Tuesday, and I'll see you later.